I'm Max Jones.
I'm Kevin Shattenkirk.
And we're going to scare some of our buddies today, so it'll be pretty funny. We're going to put Kevin in a teddy bear suit.
Z might get it. You might get a pretty good reaction out of him.
This is Trevor Zegras, and I'd like to wish you a happy holidays.
This is Trevor Zegras, and I'd
like to... Oh! Oh, my God!
That was good. That was really good.
You want a hug?
That was the best one right there. That was so good.
Oh my God!
Oh my God!
We are ready to ring in 2022. Here we go. Texier. Toe drag strides the center across for Robinson. They'll score. And the Blue Jackets go up 4-0. George Lawrence gets to it up top. D'Angelo. He'll shoot and he'll score! Back to Svechnikov. His pass and the score! And Tim Gleason to do that. Now the Canes off the draw will score! Chances were 7-0 in the period. Now it hits the frame and he'll score! The puck bounces off the stanchion and a Swiss missile for Nino Niederreiter. The Canes have come all the way back and they've tied it at 4. As Nino Niederreiter, his 10th of the season. Now Bear hammers one and they score! From the point! And in a blink of an eye, the Canes have taken the lead here in 2022. Now a turnover. Jarvis comes up with the interception. He'll spin one back in. Out in front. They'll score!
Ton of tough guys. Homer's Lincoln's trying to get to the bench. A collision.
Trocheck will get to it. Svechnikov. Empty net. Bingo! The Hurricanes had the touchdown. They kicked the extra point.
Looking for a 2-on-1. Rodriguez to the inside. He's got a chance. Fires. He scores! Shifting his way in. We're back in front. And it's Gensel. He scores! Heinen to the inside. Rodriguez, another chance. He scores! Shot, blocked by Barabana. Comes to Rock. He fires. He scores! The San Jose Sharks. Right in front. Bjorkqvist with a chance. It's loose. And they score! Marino. Rust with the shot. Score! Brian Rust! 6-1. Pittsburgh in the first.
Red Wings with a shorthanded chance. And here's a crazy one for you, Brett. The Red Wings have gone 100 games without a shorthanded goal. It's the longest stretch by any team in the NHL without a shorthanded goal since 1948.
Unbelievable.
Right back out to Burns. He lost it. And now a break for the Red Wings. Shorthanded. And they score. And the streak ends at 100 games. Can you believe it? And now the Red Wings break out again, still shorthanded. 2-on-1, Rowney across, and it's 3-0 as Bertuzzi gets a second shorty, and the wheels have come off for the Sharks' power play. Well, that's the way to end a streak, that's for sure.
Back with Jones, Kane, score! Alex to break it!
And still nearly, like you said, a full power play here for the Hawks.
Herbie Dock, throw it across, it trickles in, they score! And the Blackhawks lead. 18 seconds. That's all it took. Looking for more on the backhand. They score. How about this outburst?
Bang, bang, bang.
3-1 for Chicago. You're not seeing things at the top of the screen. It happened quickly in less than 40 seconds.
Theodore moves it around. Jonathan Marchessault looking. Richard Tip score! Here's Carrier trying to spin away from Bjornfoot. Hutton lets it rip, and he scores! A while for him. It would be his first in 15 games. And now here's Kempe the other way, and he scores! Just like that, the Kings come right back. And that's 3 goals in 39 seconds. Puck out in front to Marchessault, and he scores! What a wild first period in L.A.
How's that type of game coaches like, but it sure is entertaining.
4 goals in a minute 16.
This was about 2 hours prior to the start of tonight's game.
What do you think, Panger?
I love it. Look at the calmness, glasses, backpack. Well, Falk always has a backpack going on. And I think, didn't David Perron have a cooler?
It's only -9, fellas.
Only.
But it only feels like -24. I got a little bit of that ointment as well from the training staff of the Blues, and it takes away some of that wind sheen that you get. And he's obviously burning a little bit there with the years. That's Addison.
It's been kind of a fun night for him so far. Eddie Old told us to take a look and find him taking a spill on the way out in the ice, and he hasn't stumbled much this year. There's no question he's had a fabulous year.
The side says he's going to mix it up with Middleton.
Detroit 21, San Jose. Both guys, 5 each for
fighting.
That a boy.
What a call.
Colley in great form. Five for fighting. Way to go, West.
That is awesome.
And allow himself to get a breakaway.
Backhand try in front by Bergeron. Oh, a top popped up, and it's in the net. The Bruins answer right back.
That puck was on top of the net, Kanjan. I guess it's live, bouncing off the back of Mackenzie Blackwood.
What's interesting, will Steen be credited with his first ever National Hockey League goal? Because I'm not sure he ever touches the puck. He loosens the puck off the netting to create the play.
You're not going to see a crazier goal than that. I haven't seen that happen in a long time or ever.
Dowd a few moments ago from Hathaway and Van Riemsdyk. Look out! Eller feeds! Score! Blackwood blew it! Washington ties it at three.
A crazy bouncing dump in. Blackwood makes a poor decision, doesn't see anybody coming, whiffs on it, and it's a layup for the Caps.
In the first two periods, Nick Bonino, that's 87%. As the shot comes back to DeSmith, did it go in? It did! It's 6-3, and the Sharks score on their first shot of the third period, and it wasn't even on net.
Shot off the end wall, off the goaltender, and right there goes in the back of the net before Middleton can even hit it in.
Elliott out to play it. Gave it away, and they score! Alexei Lafreniere with the intercept.
Here comes Elliott, and now you'll see pressure from the left. Gauthier getting his stick in there. Might have forced Elliott to get rid of it a little faster than he wanted to.
And Zibanejad able to clear. Elliott plays it across, but gave it away again. Here's Goodrow to the net, and he scores!
Now, Sam, again, a misplay by the goaltender, Brian Elliott. Throws it across. It's a bad pass. Goodrow all alone in front.
Lays it down the boards. Paxton goes out to play it. Taken away by Strome. And a score! Alexei Lafreniere!
Well, the last two goals that Lafreniere has scored has been because a goaltender has made a miscue.
Offensive lines going head-to-head.
Oh, great goal! Lockett buries it into an empty net.
Oh, my.
Goals in three straight games now, and they won't come easier than that.
A planned play, and the young goaltender not knowing the boards.
Steered that one aside. Flyers still have it. Here's another one-timer, and they score!
And this is going to hit the player right in front. It's going to be Shabbat and redirect. A little bit of a knuckler, and Shabbat with the perfect tip, really.
Into traffic. Farabee. Centering pass, and that one is in the net.
I guess you never know. So I think it hit Shabbat's skate originally here. Right there. Instead of being a centering pass, it isn't.
Lays it off for Spurgeon. His drive, gloved away by Leonard. Score! Marcus Foligno jammed it in. The initial shot appeared to be going wide of the net. Leonard decided to grab it, but couldn't squeeze it.
But it goes off his glove, right to the front behind him.
To the goal line in front. Barbashev, Tarasenko, the shot, rebound, and he scores! It was tipped in! And then it goes off the skate blade of, I think, the defenseman Lindell, right there. He tries to kick it out, he kicks it in, and finishes it off.
To the midway point of nothing much.
There's a redirection, and it's into the net. Pavelski's pass went off the skates of Seth Jones, and just like that, the Stars open the scoring. It's an intended pass, kicked into the net by Jones.
Good dry settle, Nylander's got it, shoots it, fired wide, rebound, scores! Off that backboard bounce, and the Leafs have the lead.
This might even be a Nylander goal, as I thought it went off the foot of Smith. We've talked so much about the Edmonton Oilers, their inability to get the first goal, and now you got a fluky one. And now the Wild come out. The Kaprizov out in front, Zuccarello scores!
We talked a lot about the speed and the skill of Kaprizov.
He's going to get the goal, actually.
Right. One off the stick of Mikula, the defenseman. Defended by Goligoski. Moves towards the net, and they score! The Blues back on top, 2-1 St. Louis.
Not sure if it goes off of Hartman or not. It does. Another play off the stick of a defenseman.
Down to 90 seconds remaining. And now the Wild from behind the net. The centering pass from Pitlick deflects in.
It did hit a stick, went right over the left shoulder of Binnington, and again another goofy bounce here in this hockey game.
Expect the unexpected, right, Panger? And it's going to bank off the mask. First the stick, and then the mask.
misses Zaka. As Ovechkin winds up in the bench, but didn't mean to go there on purpose.
Ovi goes lateral, trying to get his team going here.
They're facing every time they get to the Islander line. That continues. And there goes that bird flying across the arena again with a shot for the point. Tipped in. Barzal went to the net. Lee was there as well. And Subban looks to the ref immediately. Something, I don't know, something thrown on the ice.
It's a deck of cards. It's a deck of cards that has opened up all over the ice. They're going to have to stop that.
They're going to have to stop this game. Yeah. I don't know if I've ever seen a deck of cards.
I never have either. And as soon as it hit the ice, it exploded. They all came out.
It is sent back up towards the point. Shot through traffic. Just goes wide of Marc-Andre Fleury. Rantanen passes blocked. And Hristov recovers in the left wing corner along the goal line. Shoots it off the outside of the net. Right back across comes McKinnon. He will move in. Shoots. Now that may have caught a piece of the post as well. And goes up and out of play.
He goes back there again, Nate McKinnon. Remember, he had the one earlier.
And exactly.
Some more love.
Some more love for the post. Look at Nate McKinnon. He's like, are you kidding me right now? I beat you clean, Flower, but I can't beat the plumbing.
Jack Johnson drives all the way below the goal line. Now wants to come around. Tries a sharp angle shot saved by Gibson. Lundestrom wants to give the puck to him, and Gibson didn't want it.
Certainly raised my heart rate a little bit. As, watch what Lundestrom says. Don't do that.
Together again. Lindgren toward the net and missed. The keg was knocked into the net.
Koskinen wouldn't let him out, so McKeg gave him a little shot, and Koskinen, who's 6 foot six, took a dive like he was at the it's a Summer Olympics.
Thompson, snapshot, off the post and out.
Wow, good rotation there by Tage Thompson.
Thompson starts the shootout, top of the first. Forehand off the post.
Well, he's hit back-to-back posts on a couple of good looks.
Cousins closing. Multiple fakes. He hit the post.
Wow. Vitek gives the post a little kiss and a nudge. It's come to the rescue. The first two shooters against the Caps.
Back on his stick. Leading goal scorer for Arizona. Works his way in, and he is denied. The San Jose Sharks have taken this one in the shootout. My goodness.
Finds Radulov looking for help. Trailer Hockenpah's stick just snapped in two as he let it go. It's almost in slow motion as it went flying. Now Hagel the other way has help in Strome. Fed there. He scores! A break on a stick leads to a break for the Hawks. And Chicago's back within a goal.
Stick betrayal. That's twice here in the second period. They've counterpunched.
Good little stop pivot move by Amadio and played back to the blue line, breaking his stick in two is Coghlan, but the shot got tipped. Now a word from Allen.
The Golden Knights think they have scored.
Oh, man. Going on here. Yeah.
I mean, it was a one-timer and a kind of a delayed reaction. The crowd didn't realize it. That puck just jammed into the back of the net. It looked like our tip-in from Brooks.
Honestly, I thought the puck went out of play, but it stuck in the net.
They should, and they're going to get a Star Wars Storm Surge.